Yes, hello there, and a warm welcome to a pretty wet Wembley, it has to be said. And if you thought your nerves couldn't take much more after last week's terrific championship playoff between Blackpool and Cardiff, then brace yourself. The final pieces of the Football League jigsaw will be put together at Wembley this weekend. Tomorrow it's the League Two playoff final as Rotherham take on Dagenham and Redbridge. Today, though, it's all about League One as Millwall meet Swindon. At stake, a place in the championship. Millwall have certainly been in the playoffs before, five times to be precise, but never experienced the joy of a playoff promotion. Their most recent attempt came just 12 months ago. They may have scored one of the playoff's best ever goals, but it wasn't enough as Scunthorpe stole the day. Millwall disposed of Huddersfield in the semi-finals to give them the chance of rewriting history and getting back to where they think they belong.
Today's the day, hopefully.
I don't know why Swindon are bothered to turn up. I suppose it's a day out in the capital for them. So I was sent to a few of them on the tube. Go and see some of the sights I was. Not make the day a complete waste of time.
Sooner or later, it's going to happen, and today's the day, definitely. We are going up, and we are
going up. We are going up. If Millwall have suffered over the years in playoffs, then the same can't be said for Swindon Town. They've reached the playoff final on three occasions and won all three of them, including the Glenn Hoddle-inspired victory over Leicester City back in 1993. Swindon booked their place at Wembley this time round by disposing of Charlton in the semis. Is it their destiny to return to the championship?
Swindon are going to Wembley!
We have a 100% record at Wembley. We won every time we've played here, we've won.
Nervous?
No, not nervous at all, mate.
Unbeaten.
Jonathan
at
Douglas
Wembley.
Has not scored this season. 1-0, Jonathan Douglas.
Swindon Town, proud club, and I think we're going to do it today.
Well, one thing's for sure, it's certainly been a thrilling season in League One. Will it have a dramatic finale? Your commentary team for this one, Martin Keown and Steve Bauer.
After 48 games of a long, arduous season, it all comes down to one more, the biggest of the lot, to decide which of these two teams will be playing in the second tier of English football next season. Swindon are back at Wembley, where they've never lost. Millwall return to the scene and the game of their heartache from just 12 months ago. Four players remain from Millwall's starting 11 that day when they were beaten by Scunthorpe, who had Liam Trotter in their victorious squad. He's back today with Millwall rather than against them. Leading scorer Steve Morrison has won and scored twice at Wembley with previous club Stevenage, while former Swindon defender Jack Smith misses out through injury, so there's a start for Sean Batt. Swindon are without skipper Gordon Greer, who was sent off at Charlton in their semi-final second leg, but Alan Sheehan is fit enough to return to a defence that also includes Kevin Akamwa. They'll look again to their big players on their big day, namely their two strikers, Billy Painter and Charlie Austin, who scored 49 of the team's 83 goals this season between them.
Millwall under Kenny Jackett, the uncompromising fashion that they play with. And, of course, Danny Wilson likes his team to pop the ball around. So, two completely different philosophies today on view.
It's a return to the championship that is the huge carrot dangled in front of these two teams, who finished third and fifth, respectively, in the regulation season. We've had heavy rain all day, so there's a real zip to the Wembley surface, which Millwall, of course, know all about from 12 months ago. Craig, the flag is down this time. It's Harris. Schofield wanted it. Harris went for goal and turned aside by David Lucas. First corner of the game goes Millwall's way.
Yeah, it's clever play, isn't it? He's just about onside. When he gets in a wide position, he's got good ability, he's clever, but he should be looking for the far post there for Morrison, who's on his own. Good start from Swindon, but at the moment Millwall taking the game to them.
Flicked on by Harris. Morrison got there. Run back by Cuthbert. He asked the goalkeeper to come. He was always second favourite, you sense there.
You know, that's just not the sort of ball Lucas is looking there for from his centre-half. They seem to go to sleep. I mean, it's a ball Harris flicks on. Morrison does OK. They seem to snuff it out. And he just stands there looking at it, Jean-Francois. And really, the keeper, I mean, in the end, it comes to nothing. But just typical sort of nervy moments. You know, it's a test playing at Wembley.
Header from Ward for Millwall. Lovely touch from Harris. Now Schofield. Morrison trying to stay onside. And he has. Steve Morrison goes for the chip. And just over the bar from Millwall's leading goal scorer.
Great bit of improvisation there, wasn't it? Manages to stay onside. Times his run perfectly. Great through ball. And look at this. Exquisite little chip. He's very unlucky there. I mean, to have the presence of mind to do that on a big occasion. And it just about goes over. So, you know, he's showing the full repertoire, isn't he? He's not just a player up the front there, a good target man. He's got good feet. And that looks good for the future.
Forward by Sheehan. Painter knew it was coming. Cleverly done. Austin took it first time. And way off target in the end. From Charlie Austin.
Yeah, I mean, his ball in. Look, Painter backing in. That's what he does well at. He just decides to hit one from distance.
Harris. Here's Sean Batt. Useful delivery towards Trotters, an own goal. The flag is up though, and it won't count. And Kevin Akamwa is mightily relieved for Swindon Town.
Well, it's actually a very good decision from the linesman because, OK, the Millwall player doesn't actually make contact with it, but he's standing in an offside position. And when it comes in, he scores an own goal, but he's only back there because you look at it when it goes wide. I think it's Bats in the middle, standing in an offside position. He whips it in, as it's played, he's offside. But he doesn't actually contact, it's the defender who ends up putting it in. I think it was Trotter in there in the end.
Here's Ward, the game beginning to open up a touch. Painter. This is Ferry. Sheehan went for goal. Always rising from Alan Sheehan. Just the one goal in Swindon colours.
Well, we've talked about Ward being doubling up on him. Suddenly the pace arrives for him. Comes inside and he hits one, and that's a decent effort.
Danny Wilson. He only took over on Boxing Day of 2008. Guided Swindon to safety last season, just 4 points above the relegation zone. And here they are at Wembley, contesting for a place in the Championship 12 months on. Here's Harris, that was misjudged by Jean-Francois. Morrison, and he went square because Harris, I think, was in an offside position. But he has won a corner.
Yes, Millwall on the break again. Difficult for them to get numbers forward because, as I say, they're so well marshalled that when they're under pressure, very defensive, relying on the pace of Morrison.
All bar one back to defend this corner for Swindon. It's a deeper one towards Morrison. He was beaten in the air by Jean-Francois. And that's another Millwall corner.
Good defending. Never easy when that ball's going fast stick. Watching the ball on your man. He's dealt with it well.
Well, Swindon have yet to have a corner in this game. They have another one to defend now, which Schofield takes. Flicked on and in! And Paul Robinson has got the touch! The Millwall skipper, who scored in the semi-final, has scored in the final, and it's first blood to Millwall.
Wow, this great moment for Millwall. The space he has in the middle of that goal. I mean, it's decent ball in, goes to him, and look at the time he's got. You wonder there, as it hit his arm, perhaps it's his shoulder, brings it down, and how do you like them? I mean, plenty of space there. I mean, he makes a habit of scoring these goals, doesn't he, Robinson? He shouldn't be getting that sort of space, especially with the record he's got scoring goals from set pieces.
Kenny Jackett applauds. Millwall in front. Good challenge by Craig and ahead of McGovern. Trotter's ball forward. Morrison's on the charge again. Half time at the moment for Swindon. Can't come quick enough.
Yeah, they've recognised now Millwall, haven't they, that put the ball in those channels and Morrison will get on his bike after it.
And he's gone for the return from Morrison. It's Harris, and still. And then he fouled the goalkeeper.
It's late, isn't it? Well, the referee's defusing this situation, but for me there, he's got a foot up. The keeper's lucky that he's not injured. Again, it's sloppy play from Swindon. They go to sleep. Little 1-2, and he's in. Good defending, and then he goes in very high. Lucky he hasn't been booked. If you look at this, goes in with his right foot, catches the goalkeeper's arm. Okay, the ball's there, but he certainly wasn't going to pull out.
Barron, Morrison. Well, the assistant's down as well. The referee's played on. It's still Morrison. This is real danger. Couldn't find a way through in the end. It all happened there. I'm not so sure the assistant was flagging for something.
Well, he certainly looked like he had his flag in the air, didn't he? And Morrison then takes him out. And he's down on his haunches there. Not really sure what he was doing. Whether he was flagging for help or whether there was an infringement, we'll never know. Maybe it was Morrison just saying, well, look, I can't believe you give that... He didn't allow that first goal. He's left a little bit on him. It's all Millwall at the moment, Steve.
Well, let's have a look at this.
Yeah, Morrison knocks it round. He's flagging. And he takes him out. And, you know, definitely got his flag in the air. But when he gets up, he just gets on with it.
With ruling out a goal as well. One way or another, Gary Bezic has had a fairly eventful first half. Now Millwall are going to be forced into a change here. Tony Craig is going to play no further part. So on in his place is Andy Frampton, who started the playoff final defeat to Scunthorpe 12 months ago. Former Brentford and Crystal Palace player. Here's Painter looking for Ward. So, as well as missing their player of the year, Alan Dunn, they're now without three fullbacks, Millwall.
Well, one thing you know about Craig is he's certainly going to have to be injured. He's, you know, he's a tough nut. He doesn't go off unless he's got a problem.
Harris, looking for Morrison. There was no flag.
Well, again, you see it. Question marks on that Swindon back line.
Swindon need the half-time whistle. And they need it quickly. So Danny Wilson, as you can see, a fairly animated figure at the moment.
I think he's upset. He's upset with his defenders. They're switching off. And you really can't afford that. Almost look like they're feeling sorry for themselves at the moment. You know, there's still 45 minutes to go here, and more, if you can get back into it. So, you know, plenty to play for. I just think Danny needs to get into these players at half-time and settle them down.
Header from Robinson, the goal scorer. Cuff that dispossesses Morrison. Flag is up at the other end now. Kenny Jackett hoping it'll be third time lucky in the playoffs. At half time, it's so far so good for Millwall. Courtesy of their skipper, Paul Robinson, 6 minutes before the break. It's his goal that gives his team the advantage at Wembley. Morrison, the outlet for Millwall again. Here he is, the leading scorer. He's looking for Bat down the middle, and Bat might just get there if he gets back on his feet here. Excellent covering challenge by Cuthbert.
Yeah, he did very well there. Saw the danger of Bat making the run, and he's got the pace to match his run, and excellent defending. It's better, though, from Swindon.
Sheehan. This is Austin. Tried to go over the central defender, and in the end, Ward was just too big and strong for him.
It is, but it just shows you now, suddenly more belief, passing it around, popping it into space, and we've got a real game on our hands.
Amankwa and Swindon try and get level in this playoff final. Painter's touch. Away by Robinson. Now Trotter for Millwall. A familiar run of Steve Morrison in the channel. Up against Cuthbert. Only Harris up with him. It's still Morrison. Cuthbert got back to do just enough.
Well, I mean, again, it's excellent defending, but Morrison's making trouble again. You know, that's the thing. Swindon taking the game to them, runs into the channel. But Cuthbert keeps his eye on the ball. He doesn't make any rash challenges, and he's there at the end. Good defending.
They've already conceded from one set play. Schofield's delivery towards Morrison. Swindon survive.
Well, you know, it's those set pieces again, it's their strength.
Watching on is a manager is hoping to win at Wembley tomorrow. That's the Rotherham boss, Ronnie Moore. They, of course, take on Dagenham in the League Two playoff final. He's here with players and staff. Forward by Frampton. He's found Harris. Now Schofield. Good play. Driven at the legs of Lucas. Won back by Jimmy Abdu. Morrison waits in the penalty area. Schofield once more. In from Harris. Oh, Trotter almost got a touch. Then to Morrison. And away by Cuthbert. Good pressure from Millwall. And it's still not clear. Schofield once again. Abdu. A disappointing end in the end from the midfielder.
Well, this is Millwall demonstrating that they can play football too. You know, it's good interchange play. It comes in, I mean, it's a good run. He's onside for me there. Keeper does exceptionally well. Two good saves in quick succession. And just a little taster from Millwall. This is the first one. Gets to the byline. And with his feet as well, the keeper does excellently well.
And this is Morrison. He's committed the foul on that occasion, but you can just see in the Swindon body language that when he gets in that position, how concerned they are.
Yeah, you can, and him and Bat, the two of them, really have got pace, and they're not afraid to use it, and that's the problem for Swindon now. As they take the game to Millwall, just going to leave those areas open, just need to be careful. So far they've been able to resist any of the breaks from Millwall, but big moment now for Swindon.
Sheehan's delivery. Header from Amankwa. Austin deflected. Corner to Swindon.
Yeah, he demonstrates that he's going to shoot. You know, give me a yard. He holds it up well. Good strength.
McGovern's delivery. Flatter one this time. Free header for Jean-Francois and plucked out of the air by Ford.
It's a good save. Gets loads of space, a long way out though, and he gets a good connection on it, and in the end it's a fine save from the keeper. But look, he's going away from the goal, difficult to generate that power that you need.
Abdu. Morrison. It's opened up from here. It's still Steve Morrison. Didn't really contain enough power to trouble Lucas in the end.
Well, he's done everything right, hasn't he? You know, great run. Comes inside on his weaker left foot and really should be testing the goalkeeper a bit more than that. Yeah, we're just looking at him again, going through Morrison. You know, the informed player, really. Look at him, he comes inside. He's so confident. He gallops past two defenders. And does nothing at the end of it.
Jean-Francois in ahead of Morrison, helped on by Danny Ward. Oh, the mistake, and this could be the moment. It's Charlie Austin for Swindon Town, and he's missed it. A golden opportunity. and Charlie Austin couldn't hit the target.
Well, would you believe it? Look at this, he just puts it in his path and off goes Austin, and you think it's just going to be a formality, and then puts it wide. I mean, I'm just wondering whether the ball lifts as he goes to play it, but really he should be hitting the target at the very least there. Look at it, bobble. In fairness, it takes a bobble, and you wonder if the pitch has played its part again there. The last thing you want to do as a defender is to make an elementary mistake. But Austin, you know, look at him, I think this takes a bobble. Look at this ball just sit up as he goes to hit it. You've got to feel sorry for him there. Done everything right, and it's just lifted off the ground as he goes to play it.
And here's Morrison bulldozing his way through. And then the effort over the crossbar. Just brushed aside Jean-Francois.
He's just a little reminder, isn't it, Morrison again? You know, nudges the defender off the ball. He's strong and he's prepared to hit it from distance, and had his technique been better there, he might well have tested the keeper.
Darby into Douglas, couldn't get through Trotter. Now, could there be a Millwall break on here? Harris one way, Morrison the other. Here's Harris. Hackett's made his way into the penalty area as well. Harris went for the curler, and it wasn't curling enough.
Well, decent effort. Right-sided play is always going to come onto his... He's got so much space, just hasn't got the technique again at the end of it. You know, you wonder if Millwall really will regret these opportunities that they're getting if Swindon can get back into it.
Morrison again making a nuisance of himself, caught there by Jean-Francois. That is going to be the first yellow card of this final.
Well, it's him that gives the ball away in the first place. Sloppy play, he's slow to react. Morrison again, cashes in, no complaints, it's a booking. Just feel Swindon not playing the ball quick enough. They've got to, that's their game, pass the ball quickly. And I think players are sort of losing belief in the occasion. Keep moving it quickly and things will happen. Don't give Millwall time to get back in position.
Scott Barron to take the free kick for Millwall. Goalkeeper's come a long way again, he didn't get anywhere near it, and it's cleared by Cuthbert from virtually off the line. Then away by Jean-Francois, and then by Billy Painter. It was all a little desperate.
Certainly was, wasn't it? I mean, you know, he's come an awful long way. I mean, I'm not sure it's his ball at all. He just doesn't get off the ground.
Cleared by Barron. Morrison again, effortlessly takes it in his stride. Morrison!
He's certainly got some energy, that boy. I mean, he's a willing runner. It's a nightmare for the defenders, never gives up on anything. He's run all those channels all afternoon. Just that quality at the end of it. You feel with a little bit of fine-tuning, though, there could be a real prospect on Millwall's hands here. He's done incredibly well this season, but I think there's still some improving to do.
Robinson, still his goal that separates the two. But for how much longer? Because Morrison is onside here. It's still Steve Morrison, and still blocked by Lucas. Scrambled away. Picked up now by Trotter. And Hackett, who drove it at pace. It came off Darby, and it's a Millwall corner.
Well, how many times have we said it today? I mean, he's running in the channels here for fun. And look at him again. He's on his bike. He's onside. And now it's about decision-making. He goes to the byline. He comes inside. For me now, he should be pulling that ball back to the edge of the box there, or just into the six-yard line. Decision-making at the top level is all important.
Harris and Cuthbert just being told to calm down in there prior to this Millwall corner. In from Barron, came off Darby, right across the face of goal for another corner.
Tell you what, that was an important interception, wasn't it? You're wondering where the goalkeeper is again in this one. It's whipped in. And that's on its way in the back of the net if he doesn't get a touch.
Schofield decides on the more direct delivery. And that's a little more comfortable for David Lucas in the Swindon goal. Time is ticking away. We're into the last 6 minutes. Amankwa. Pericard's waiting. Goes down more in hope than anything else. Referee just shook his head. Back in again towards Austin. Ford made an early decision and it was a good one.
Yeah, you wondered. Yeah. Good defending in the end, wasn't it? So strong and solid. I think Danny's wondering if that's come off his hand. It's difficult to see from where he is, certainly from where we are.
Ferry, Pericard. Austin waits. Austin tried to get a touch, there wasn't one. And Ward shot in the end, right across the face of goal.
You know, you're looking at Ward, what are we now, the 89th minute? We've just not seen him in the game enough. It comes onto his left foot, flashing across the box. But really, this boy has got a lot more to offer than we've seen today. He'll be disappointed. These fans are going to go back now to Wiltshire, disappointed.
Jean-Francois. Ferry. Didn't reach O'Brien. Last minute, last chance saloon for Swindon. In from Ferry, away by Ward. They need to pick this second ball up. It's Austin. Amankwa. It's all about the quality of delivery now. Over Douglas. Austin slipped, blocked, and then the goalkeeper parries and wide for a corner.
Wow, wow. I mean, the goalkeeper there. He's flapped at this. It's Austin. He slips, still manages to get something on it. Keeper goes and it just goes through his hands.
Last chance saloon. The goalkeeper Lucas is up for this as well. It needs to be a good one. It was a dreadful one. And it's headed away comfortably by Morrison. The last few seconds. Back in from Derby, but it's to no avail. After four seasons away, Millwall are back in the Championship. And for Kenny Jackett and his team, those horrible memories of 12 months ago are replaced by scenes of sheer joy. And Paul Robinson, the captain, Mr. Millwall, the man who's come through the system, is the goal scorer that gets them there in the end. Neil Harris there finally wins a playoff for Millwall. They've been in the playoffs on five occasions before today and haven't won any of them. And finally, they have that winning feeling in the playoffs. And 12 months after they had the tears of despair that Swindon are now experiencing, it's tears of joy for Millwall. They are heading towards the second tier of English football.
Well, I mean, Millwall deserved it on the day. I thought their midfield, Abdu, it was like they're gluing the team for them. And Trotter, very strong, powerful. And how fitting is Robinson scoring the winning goal again? And Swindon, of course, their players are devastated. Austin, you know, he's inconsolable. But I feel if Balls took a bobble, you know, I think he can be proud of what he's done so far this season. He's a young man, it's early of his career, he's playing non-league football pool at the start of the season. They'll come back again, Swindon, but today, it's Millwall's day.
Hallelujah! You are in the playoffs.
We've done it. We've absolutely done it. I feel sorry for those guys there, that mob, because we felt that last year. So, you know, commiserations to them. But I think over the course of two seasons, we've deserved that.
What a way to spend your 400th appearance for the club, eh?
Well, it'd be nice to have a goal, wouldn't it? But, no, delighted, absolute delight. 400 and promotion.
Many congratulations.
Clem, thank you. Thank you.
You must be gutted, son.
Yeah, but somebody's got to lose, and I've had both feelings before, so we'll get over it and come stronger next season.
Too early to take positives out of the season, which have been a considerable amount, David.
Definitely. I think we've been really consistent, and we've got a really young team, so, like I say, we'll come again stronger.
They know what Swindon are going through, but this is their moment. They used last year's disappointment in terms of a positive motivation. They didn't want to experience that feeling again. They wanted to go one better, and that's exactly what they've done. Paul Robinson shakes the hands, gets his medal. The one club man, the goal-scoring hero of today, takes a couple of deep breaths. He's going to take this moment in. So the man who came through Millwall's youth system, who scored the all-important goal today, raises the trophy in official confirmation that after four seasons away, Millwall are back in the Championship. And 12 months on from being inconsolable, having lost this final, they've used it as motivation to go one better. And this is a day that will live long in the memory. And Kenny Jackett, at the third time of asking, he gets his medal. And just listen to the cheer now for the man who's led Millwall back into the second tier of English football.
So near and yet so far.
It's always going to be the case, whoever is in this position, isn't it? You know, what can you say? I think you did tip your hat to Millwall. They were in this position last year, 2-0 up, lost 3-2, devastated. And I remember watching the game myself and feeling like I don't really want to feel like that. I know exactly how Kenny feels at the moment. But we've got to use it as a positive. We've got to use that you can bounce back, and you can if you're brave enough, you know, and strong enough to challenge again. I think we can do it again. It's not overshadowed a great season. We've had a fantastic season. We've had some great performances, great results, some fantastic individual performances throughout that campaign. But you know, the bottom line is it's on 90 minutes, and unfortunately we haven't been able to push it forward.
I was going to say it had to be one of your stalwarts. It was either going to be Neil Harris or it was going to be Paul Robinson, the two guys that are inextricably linked to this club.
Yeah, Robbo's had a great season as well. You know, I'm really pleased for him. After his injury last year, I mean, he missed last year, just came on 1 or 2 minutes after getting injured at Christmas, you know. He's been fantastic this season, I'm really pleased for him.
Share with us, when that whistle goes and your work reaches this momentous result, what is it that goes through you? Relief, jubilation, what?
Yeah, first off, it's relief, has come here and won, which is a big thing. And then after that, you see the crowd, you know. It's a great club, Millwall, and they really came into play today.
Absolutely delighted.
Thank
for
you,
Glenn. Thanks, Kenny.
So much class position and leaving my side tonight.
Well, I think it's captain's privilege, isn't it? You're allowed to actually go and sleep with it in your bed tonight.
I like to think so, considering I scored the winner tonight. I think my missus will have to move over. This one's coming next to me, I think.
I don't blame you for that. Millwall's sixth attempt, fourth attempt for you to win by the playoffs. You must be absolutely cock-a-hoop.
Absolutely delighted, and it's just a reward from all those fans that have, you know, supported us over those harder times. And, you know, defeat was hard last year, but to come back and win, you know, shows great mental strength from the lads, and it's a great reward, and wow, what a day.
It's the start of what will be a long and very eventful party. And a party where the invitation list will go on forever. They've waited 12 long months to put the record straight, and now they have the opportunity. As Millwall wave goodbye to League One in spectacular fashion.
Yeah, so very well done to Millwall. Let's get the thoughts of Leroy Rossini. Millwall over the 90 minutes, Leroy. Deserved victors?
Absolutely. You know, the first half, they started the game, they were very, very strong. Never allowed Swindon to really get into the game. I think there's a bit of nerves there on the Swindon side as well, but Millwall took advantage of that. I thought Morrison and Harris up front were outstanding in the first half. They always linked up and they always looked more dangerous.
They had the ball in the back of the net after, what, half an hour? Ruled for offside. Right decision by the referee?
Absolutely right. His assistant got it, but spot on. As the ball's crossed by back, you just see the Trotter's in offside position. Kevin Lamanqua runs back to defend it, heads it into his own net. But as that ball goes in, Trot becomes active and correct decision.
Well, Millwall's domination eventually told, didn't it? And it came at a crucial time in the game.
Absolutely. If Swindon could have held out to half-time, it might have been a different story. But Millwall had the upper hand towards the end of that first half. And it came from a corner. And Neil Harris makes a great run across in their post. He takes Cuthbert under the ball. He actually flicks it on. And Robinson is in the right position. He's wrong side of Billy Painter. Yeah, yeah. But you know what? The finish is excellent because he could have easily put that over
he
the crossbar.
Didn't panic.
No, absolutely. The ball's bounced up. You see so many centre-halves put it over the crossbar. But Paul Robinson's been in that position so many times. Calmly just sticks it in the back of the net and it was to prove to be decisive.
Swindon looked a different side in the second half, didn't they? And I mean, they started on fire. And Charlie Austin had a great chance with 18 minutes left, one-on-one. You almost put your house on him scoring.
Absolutely. I mean, they got on the front foot in the second half, and I think Millwall sort of allowed them to come on to him, wanted to play on the break. And then it's a mistake by Paul Robinson, ironically, and Charlie Austin's got all that space. He does everything right, goes across the face of Paul Robinson, so he's got the keeper to beat, and just as he goes to put it in the back of the net, it takes a terrible bobble, and it just flies wide. And you just saw then, as that ball went past the post, all Swindon's chances went as well.
Talking of Austin, both him and Billy Painter didn't quite gel up front today. I mean, they've been such a potent force for Swindon all season. I suppose, was that the main difference between the two sides? Because Morrison and Harris, I mean, you know, they're making nuisances of themselves today.
Absolutely. I thought that Ward and Robinson at the back for Millwall was so strong. I thought Swindon missed their captain, Greer, at the back. But Morrison and Harris, they linked up play really, really well, started off things for them. And the second half, when they played on the counter-attack, Morrison got into loads of good positions, didn't finish it off, but they always looked the more dangerous strike force.
So Millwall joined Norwich and Leeds into the Championship. I mean, these are three big sides. Their infrastructure is made for Championship football almost.
Absolutely. They won't be worried about going into that league. And, you know, I'm sure that they'll get backed as well. And there'll be players who want to go and play at big clubs like that in the fantastic stadiums that they've got. So there'll be no problem with them going into the Championship and making an impact.
Thanks, Leroy. And don't forget, we'll have the final chapter of the Football League season. We'll have the best of the League Two playoff final tomorrow night as Dagenham and Redbridge take on Rotherham. Highlights of that can be seen at 11:25. on BBC One. So commiserations to Swindon, well done to Millwall. In 12 months, they've gone from losers to Wembley winners. Thanks to an inspirational role from their captain, Paul Robinson, the Lions have got their pride back. From all of us here at Wembley, good night.